been 2 days, but since two important meeting is going on in principal chambers, that is a ethical committee meeting, and simultaneously MBBS examination is also going on. So many faculties are busy for MBBS examination. And this is purely, I have to tell, first of all, on behalf of the high-tech group of institutions, last year our Honorable Chairman was present from the beginning till end. But unfortunately, my respected Honorable Chairman is out of headquarters to Tirupati, along with the managing trustee whom we have invited. But in our hospital, we have got a very good medical superintendent, Dr. Basudev Behera, whom I will invite. Then I will request, as a resource person, everybody knows Dr. Sanjit Patnaik. He is a very famous man, has attended. My only appeal is that I was invited to attend a meeting in Capital Hospital regarding the DOT activities in High-Tech Medical College. But here, one thing madam has told me, TB is not a business of pulmonary medicine. So TB can occur to any clinical department, gynecology, orthopedic, eye, skin and BD, and TB chest, pediatric, from pediatric to geriatric. But the number of cases which we are getting mostly from pulmonary medicine. That is why these figures were very low as discussed in the government level. So madam has requested me to call the clinical people, and I have gone personally along with a staff. He is a staff, Surya Babu. Where is Surya Babu? Stand up. He is a sponsored man of Government of Odisha, sitting from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. giving anti-tubercular drug. Two tests we are doing, and I am sorry to tell, many of my faculty, junior hook, senior hook, they do not know where DOT is functioning in High-Tech Medical College. Where is
Madam Chali Raujati, synopsis, Adi, synopsis review meeting. Activities of DMC DOT Center. Regency established on 8/11/2019. This gentleman is deputy. Analysis of data conducted AB and CBNAT. Next, sir, from November 2019, month of February, January, for the issue. Okay, take off. Grand total patient, 420. Slide pass of Baroka Didita Sapula said. Positive,
zero answer.
Next slide. So from 2019, December 20, CBNAT 78. Out of 78, 19 positive, rest are negative. Out of 19 positive cases, 2 cases are MDR, multiple drug resistant. Then from January 2021 till now, total CBNAT is 13. Out of 13 cases, 2 cases are positive, 7 cases are negative, and 4 cases reports are awaited. Total CBNAT sample till now is 91. Total positive till now is 21. Total negative till now is 70. Total MDR till now is 20. Now I would like to request our resource persons to speak.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good ev This is our Honorable Chairman, inaugurated Dot Center in third floor, second circle. This is also Dot Center inauguration in 2019. Third, ex-Vada TV head was present and both of them are WHO consultants, conducted in 2020. Next, this is the speech of Dr. Tirupati Panigrahi and TV authorities, resource persons who are present. Next, Siddhesh Babu is there, resource person, and this is the last slide. I think it is last slide. This is, the gathering was very good, 2 days. So this is the doctor's slide I am giving, who has attended. Next, pulmonary medicine department, the best doctor of medicine, Jahangir was there. So all are present. Unfortunately, today they cannot come for the examination. How shall I thank you? Thank you. Now I will request our respected resource person, sir, will speak. Nursing superintendent one, please come. Pulmonary, Tapatabashibo, pulmonary medicine. Pulmonary medicine, come one. Idris sir.
So much, sir. Thank you.
Gopi Baba, thank you. All the arrangements, Gopi sir has done it. Credit goes to him.
Sir, I boys are eight days of Gori Bartun. Sir, Kabutra.
Tapare, Mood Akili, Faculty, Upper Hospital Pediatric. Nursing staff is only asked to anybody come.
आसला आम चेष्टा करूचु टीबी को कंट्रोल करने एलिमिनेट करने इराडिकेट करने कि आज पर्यंत आम करूँ डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम्स या भितर नेशनल कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम आसला तापर रिवाइज्ड है रिवाइज्ड नेशनल ट्यूबरक्लोसिस कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम तापर पुणी है जे टेक्निकल ऑपरेशन गाइडलाइन आसला तापर रिवाइज्ड टेक्निकल ऑपरेशन गाइडलाइन आसला तापर एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम नेशनल ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम वर्तमान आम नेशनल टीबी एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम जाऊँ आमर टार्गेट रही 2025 सुधा आम टीबी को एलिमिनेट करने आम कमिटेड से डिफरेंट लेवल सब प्रकार अरेंजमेंट कराई सब प्रकार लेटेस्ट डायग्नोस्टिक प्रोसीजर्स लाइक सीबीनेट्स मॉलिक्यूलर डायग्नोसिस लिक्विड कल्चर सॉलिड कल्चर आउ सीबीनेट आउ ट्रूनेट ये सब इन्वेस्टिगेशन द्वारा आम डायग्नोसिस करूचु आउ अर्ली डायग्नोसिस करके अर्ली ट्रीटमेंट दबा लेटेस्ट मेडिसिन भी आम बर्तमान दौर विडाक्विन डेलामिनेट टाइप टाइप दूचु से आम सब प्रकार चेस्टा करूँ जमी 2025 सुधा कमिट करने आमर जितेक मेडिकल कॉलेज भुवनेश्वर अच्छी ताकि हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज प्रोफेसर मित्रों द्वारा चेष्टा आम एटी डीएमसी डेजिग्नेटेड माइक्रोस्कोप सेंटर करके आम डॉट सेंटर आउ डीएमसी करके आम विगत 2 वर्ष है कम करुँ आपण मानक सहयोगे आम ये भल कम देखु आम भल कम हो स्टिल देन मु रिक्वेस्ट करी आमर हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज स्टाफ मानक जे नेशनल नॉर्म हिसाब से आमर ओपीडी जी अटेंडेंस हुए सब डिपार्टमेंट ओपीडी जी अटेंडेंस हुए ସେଥିରେ ମିନିମମ୍ ହେଉଛି ରେଫରାଲ୍ ପ୍ରିଜର୍ଭେଟିଭ୍ କେସ୍ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ମିନିମମ୍ 5% ଦରକାର ଆମକୁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ଏଠି 5% ଆମେ ହେଉନି। 5% ହେଲେ ଆମର ଡିଟେକ୍ସନ୍ କେସ୍ ବଢ଼ିବ, ଡିଟେକ୍ସନ୍ କେସ୍ ବଢ଼ିଲେ ଆମର ଆମେ ଆର୍ଲି ଟ୍ରିଟମେଣ୍ଟ କରିକି ଆର୍ଲି କ୍ୟୁର୍ କରିପାରିବା। ଆଉ ସେ ମୁଁ ରିକ୍ୱେଷ୍ଟ କରିବି ଆମର ସବୁ ଓପିଡ଼ିରେ ସାର୍ ମାନେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ବସୁଛନ୍ତି ଓପିଡ଼ିରେ, ସେମାନେ ଟିକେ ଟିବିକୁ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ରଖନ୍ତୁ, ଆଉ ଯେତିକି ପ୍ରିଜର୍ଭେଟିଭ୍ କେସ୍ ଆସୁଛି ତାକୁ ରେଫର୍ କରନ୍ତୁ ଫର୍ ସ୍ପୁଟମ୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍ସ। ଆମର ଲାଟେଷ୍ଟ ଟେକ୍ନିକ୍ ଦ୍ୱାରା ଆମର ଏଠି ଏକ୍ଜାମିନେସନ୍ ହେବ, ଆଉ ଯେଉଁ କେସ୍ ଦରକାର ହେଉଛି ସେଇଟା ସିବିନାଟ୍ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଆମର କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲକୁ ଯାଉଛି। ସିବିନାଟ୍ ଆମର ଭୁବନେଶ୍ୱରରେ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲରେ ସିବିନାଟ୍ ଅଛି, ଆର୍ଏମ୍ଆର୍ସିରେ ଅଛି, ଆଉ ଏମ୍ସରେ ଅଛି, ତିନି ଜାଗାରେ ଆମର ସିବିନାଟ୍ ମେସିନ୍ ଫଙ୍କସନ୍ କରୁଛି। ମୁଁ ଆଶା କରେ ସମସ୍ତେ ରେଫର୍ କରିବେ, 5-10% ଇଭିନ୍ ଏବେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଆମର ମ୍ୟାନେଜିଂ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟର ଏନ୍ଏଚ୍ଏମ୍ର, ସେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଯେ 5% ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ସଫିସିଏଣ୍ଟ, ୟୁ ଟେଲ୍ ଦେମ୍ ଫର୍ 10% ରେଫରାଲ୍। ସୋ ଆମର ଯେତିକି ରେଫରାଲ୍ ହେଲେ ଯାଇକି ଆମର ଡିଟେକ୍ସନ୍ ବଢ଼ିବ, ଡିଟେକ୍ସନ୍ ବଢ଼ିଲେ ଆମେ ଟ୍ରିଟମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେଇକି କ୍ୟୁର୍ କରିପାରିବୁ। ମୁଁ ଆଶା କରେ ଆମ ସାର୍ଙ୍କ ଚେଷ୍ଟାରେ ଆମର ଏଠି ରେଫରାଲ୍ କେସ୍ ବଢ଼ିବ, ଆମେ ସବୁ କେସ୍କୁ ଏଠି ଡିଟେକ୍ଟ କରିକି ଆମେ ଟ୍ରିଟମେଣ୍ଟ କରିକି କ୍ୟୁର୍ କରିବୁ। ସେଥିପାଇଁ ଆମର ଆଜି ଆମର ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ର ଟ୍ରେନର୍ ଆମେ ଆଣିଛୁ, ଆମର ସେ ହେଉଛନ୍ତି ସୁପରିନଟେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ ବି ଥିଲେ ଆମର ATDC କଟକର ଏସ୍ସି ସୁପରିନଟେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ ଥିଲେ, ବହୁତ ଦିନ ହେଲା ସୁପରିନଟେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ କାମ କରିଛନ୍ତି, ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ର ଜଣେ ଟ୍ରେନର୍, ଭେରି ଭେରି ଫେମସ୍ ଟ୍ରେନର୍, ଆଉ ଆମେ ଆଶା କରୁଛୁ ସେ ପୁରା ଆମର ଏଇ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ୍ର ଟେକ୍ନିକାଲ୍ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟସ୍କୁ ସେ ଡିଟେଲ୍ସ ଭାବରେ କହିବେ, ଆପଣମାନେ ଟିକେ ଶୁଣିବେ। ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ଭେରି ମଚ୍।
ଭେରି ଗୁଡ୍ ମର୍ଣ୍ଣିଂ ରେସ୍ପେକ୍ଟେଡ୍ ସୁପରିନଟେଣ୍ଡେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରଫେସର ମିତ୍ର, ଡକ୍ଟର ଖା, ଫାକଲ୍ଟିଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ହାଇଟେକ୍ ମେଡ଼ିକାଲ କଲେଜ, ପୋଷ୍ଟ ଗ୍ରାଜୁଏଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଦର ଅଗଷ୍ଟ ଗ୍ୟାଦରିଂ ଓଭର ହିୟର, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରିଭିଲେଜ୍ ଟୁ ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ବିଫୋର୍ ୟୁ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର୍ଲି ପ୍ରଫେସର ମିତ୍ର, ହୁ ହାଜ୍ ବିନ୍ ମାଇ ଟିଚର୍ ଡ୍ୟୁରିଂ ମାଇ ଅଣ୍ଡର ଗ୍ରାଜୁଏଟ୍ ଡେଜ୍। ସୋ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସାର୍ ଫର୍ ୟୁର ଟିଚିଂସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ବ୍ଲେସିଂସ୍ ଟୁଡେ, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଏଭର୍ ଆଇ ହାଭ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ପୋଜିସନ୍। ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସାର୍। So, coming to this National Tuberculosis Elimination Program, you know TB has been a social problem and it is a multi-sectoral approach. So, overcrowding, poor housing, indoor air pollution, tribal, migrants, diabetes, HIV, other comorbid conditions, smoking, silicosis, they all contribute to this, and so it has to be a multi-sectoral approach. TB should not be treated in isolation. Coming to the global versus India statistics, you see the incidence of TB is very much, and India contributes more than 1/4 of the total TB incidence. Similarly, the mortality rate is around 30%, and it again contributes for incidence of TB and HIV around 11%, mortality of HIV and TB around 4%, MDR TB around 27%, and children with TB around 31%. We have been in the number one position for many bad reasons, TB being one of them. Coming to the end of TB strategy, it is based on the 3 pillars and 4 principles: integrated patient-centered TB care and prevention, bold policies and supportive systems, intensified research and innovation. Coming to the vision, goals and targets, so vision is a world free of tuberculosis, that is zero TB deaths, zero TB disease and zero TB sufferings. So the end of TB strategy, the WHO has given the call so that by 2035 there should be a reduction of incidence around 95%, and TB affected families, there should not be any catastrophic cost, so the TB care, the treatment, identification should be totally free of cost. Coming to the Odisha updates, so as of 2020, last year, as you know, because of this pandemic COVID, the case, suspected cases has come down from 116 per lakh, which should be actually not the correct figure. However, the notification from the public sector was around 40,334 annually, from the private sector 5,268, and the total being 45,000. And as per these estimates, still we are missing out around 43,000 cases annually. So remember, 43,000 cases are being missed in Orissa alone. So as Dr. Khan had already highlighted in the previous deliberation, this National TB Control Program is not a new program. It was there in our country from the 1962s. So it was known as the National TB Control Program or the NTCP, and which was almost ran for around 30 years in this country till 1992. And when in 1993 this was evaluated, it was found, unfortunately, it did not give the desired results as it was. So that is why this National TB Control Program was reviewed with the WHO and with the Government of India, and it was revised and brought in the name of Revised National Tuberculosis Control Program or the RNTCP, and the entire nation was covered by 2006 March. What were the landmark achievements during this RNTCP? So policy and system preparedness for universal access to TB care, including mandatory notification of TB cases. So universal access, what does that mean? So no patient, no TB patient in the country should be deprived of the opportunity of being diagnosed and treated. Development of the standard of TB care in India. Case-based notification or the NICSHA. Rapid molecular diagnostic test, renovations and universal access to TB care. Innovation and use of information and communication to monitor for the adherence of tuberculosis. Then the drug susceptibility testing, introduction of newer drugs like the bidaquiline and the delaminin, TB and comorbidities. As I told you earlier, TB should not be treated in isolation. If the patient is having a comorbid condition like diabetes or HIV, unless they are treated simultaneously, TB is not going to be cured. Pediatric TB, nutritional support including DBT, active and intensive case finding, urban TB control modules, progressive advocacy and communication. Earlier, when the program started, it was a passive detection. That means it was expected that the patient should come so motor to the system and report. But now the strategy has changed. We go for active detection or the intensive case finding. Coming to the challenges of this program. So the spread of the human deficiency virus has been a big challenge. Emergence of the drug-resistant tuberculosis has been also a big threat. And unregulated private sector has also been a challenge to this, which we will discuss subsequently. Coming to the symptoms of tuberculosis, you all know. So any cough for 2 weeks or more, fever for 2 weeks, significant weight loss, night sweats, hemoptysis or blood in the cough, swelling of the lymph nodes, loss of appetite, no weight gain or loss in weight. And basically, anatomically, if you divide, it will be divided into two classifications, that is pulmonary TB or extrapulmonary TB. And as you all know, almost 80 to 85% constitutes the pulmonary TB, and 15 to 20% hardly extrapulmonary TB. And if the patient is having both pulmonary and extrapulmonary, it should be mentioned as pulmonary TB, and the site of the extrapulmonary should be mentioned. Coming to the four symptom complex of screening for particularly people living with HIV, here there should be a fast tracking. So in that case, you have to go for the four symptom complex, that is current cough, that means cough of any duration, even with a history of 1 day, fever, weight loss, night sweats. Similarly, for the pediatric cases of children, current cough, fever, poor weight gain, and history of contact with the TB case within the last 2 years is a very pertinent history and should raise suspicion. So diagnosis of TB. So what are the things we have? Smear microscopy, chest radiography, CBNAT. Coming to the diagnostic tools. So what are the diagnostic tools which the program offers? So we have the microbiological confirmation. We have two methods. The smear microscopy, which has the ZM staining or the Jill-Nielsen staining, and the other is the fluorescent staining. Similarly for culture, we have the solid culture, the liquid culture, and now the rapid molecular diagnostic methods of the line probe assay, LPA, or the nucleic acid amplification test, or the NAT method. So this is how you all know a Mycobacterium tuberculosis looks under the oil immersion lens in the ZM staining. Similarly, in the ornament staining with the back background, solid culture, liquid culture at the MGIT, which can process around 960 samples in 42 days time. Then the gene expert or the CBNAT. This is the Catridge batch nucleic acid amplification test. And what is the turnaround time? So the turnaround time for the solid is around 84 days. That of the liquid culture is 42 days. The LPA around 72 hours and CBNAT 2 hours. Other diagnostic tools. So we have the radiography. So using a tool, because you know chest X-ray or radiography is a very, very sensitive, but it is not very specific. So any X-ray should be evaluated for tuberculosis. Then the TST or the standard TST, this is has a supplementary role only in children or pediatric cases, not for the adults. And IGRA or the interferon gamma release assay is no more recommended in countries like India where there is high prevalence. So about chest radiography, as you know, high and inter and intra-reader variation. Various studies have shown that patients who are diagnosed only on X-ray, subsequently when they are evaluated, there was an error of around 40 to 70%, because as you know, no X-ray is pathognomonic of tuberculosis, but an X-ray patch should be evaluated for tuberculosis. X-ray will show you the site of the lesion, but will never tell you about the etiology of the lesion. जैसे हर चमकता चीज सोना नहीं होता, वैसे हर एक्सरे का धब्बा टीबी नहीं होता. So that you should keep it in mind. But again, I repeat, any X-ray patch should be evaluated for tuberculosis. Other diagnostic tests, the serological tests, particularly many serological tests are available in the market, the TB Gold, the Mycodot, that people are prescribing. Please don't, because there is no serological test as of now in this world to confirm tuberculosis. It is a test which actually gives happiness both to the patient, the provider, because the patient feels he has spent 500 rupees on a test and he has got a test result. And the laboratory where it has gone, he also makes an income. But actually it has no role to play. So that is why government of India has banned it. Coming to sputum collection for the sputum smear microscopy. Remember, the sample has to be a quality sample. So usually for diagnosis, two samples have to be collected. One is spot when the patient comes to the OPD, and if he is thought to be having tuberculosis, a spot sample is to be collected. Another container has to be given so that he comes the next morning with a overnight sample. Many a times we see that the patients fail to turn up for the second sample. Under such exceptional condition, a second sample can be collected after a gap of 1 hour. Then the patient, the sample which is to be sent for CBNAT or for the culture, it has to be collected in a Falcon tube. Remember, this is a sterilized tube, Falcon tube. But for smear microscopy, you never require a Falcon tube. Any sputum container which is available can be used. But for a CBNAT test or for a culture, it has to be collected in a conical Falcon tube, at least, which is a capacity of 50 ml, the volume should be at least 2 to 5 ml. Coming to the diagnostic algorithm. So you see, why this diagnostic algorithm? Doctors in our country, they know how to identify a case of tuberculosis. But in the program condition, you have to have certain standards, which is the minimum things which are required to be done to identify case of tuberculosis. So a presumptive TB, as I told you, that means presumptive TB means persons who are having cough for 2 weeks, fever, blood in the sputum. So these things, they have to turn to be presumptive TB, and you suspect a presumptive TB, you should subject him for smear examination, and if X-ray is available in the same setting, they should also go for an X-ray. And if the smear is positive, then it is microbiologically confirmed TB. If the smear is positive but X-ray is not suggestive, still you can go, it is just microbiologically confirmed. If the smear is negative and X-ray is suggestive of TB, then you go for a sample for the seminar. And if smear is negative or not available and on high clinical suspicion, you can send the sample to the seminar. The idea of this diagnostic algorithm is that you do not require any other battery of tests unnecessarily, which is time consuming and expensive for the patient. With this minimum smear microscopy and X-ray, you can rule out whether it is tuberculosis or not. Coming to the integrated drug resistant tuberculosis. So earlier what used to happen, there was no such system in the program to diagnose drug resistant tuberculosis. So what used to happen, only when the patient was already on the first line of treatment, after the patient failed the first line of treatment, the sample used to be collected, it was sent to Bengaluru for a solid culture, and by the time we get the result, it was more than 3 to 6 months time. And many a time we lose the patient. So here we have an occasion of the seminar where you can rule out, you see, all diagnosed TB patients also, they are diagnosed for TB, but to know whether they are resistant or not, right from the beginning, we offer them UDST or the Universal Drug Susceptibility Testing, for which the seminar machine is available. The advantage of seminar machine is, along with detection of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it can detect rifampicin resistance or not. It will only detect rifampicin resistance or not, and if it is rifampicin resistance, the patient is termed as drug resistant tuberculosis. So right within a fortnight, you can know whether you have to put the patient on the first line treatment or you switch over to the drug resistant tuberculosis. So this is the diagnostic algorithm. In short, I will just tell you. So when the sample is subject for seminar, so either you get a RSTB on the left hand side, that means rifampicin sensitive TB. And if it is, the first line treatment starts. Then simultaneously you put the sample also for the first line LPA. If it is INH resistance, then you go for the INH monopoly resistance. If it is sensitive, continue with the first line treatment. Similarly, on the right hand pathway you see, if it is RRTB or rifampicin resistance, then you straight away start with the shorter MDR regimen, which is 9 to 11 months. And then put the sample also for the second line LPA, because along with rifampicin resistance, it could be resistant to the fluoroquinolones or the second line injectables. And depending upon the results of whether it is fluoroquinoline or the second line injectable sensitive or resistance, you continue this MDR regimen or switch over to the new drug regimen. So this is in brief, that is how with the diagnostic algorithm that guides you what type of treatment you should be giving to the patient. So as of now, there are around 40 seminar machines. All district headquarter hospitals are having one seminar machine. Along with that, as Dr. Khan has mentioned, RMRC Bhubaneswar is having one, Capital Hospital is having another one, some subdivisions, medical colleges, they are also having a seminar machine, and gradually also it will be distributed and decentralized. So why seminar, particularly in people living with HIV? So as I told you, you know, HIV is such a condition where the tuberculosis can be aggravated. So to detect this patient, for fast tracking of these patients, instead of going for smear microscopy, and here the bacilli, they are possibacillary cases, the sensitivity of seminar is very high. It can detect up to 10 AFB per ml. Whereas in a sputum microscopy, unless the bacilli load is more than 10,000 AFB per ml of sputum, it cannot detect. So the sensitivity of sputum microscopy is hardly 40 to 60% in comparison. But in a program condition, all samples cannot be sent to the seminar. So gradually as the seminar machines increase, probably that could be distributed even to the DMC level. So low sensitivity, fewer organisms in the sputum, culture is highly specialized and time consuming. So that is why seminar. The evidences and advantages being sensitive and specific, increased case detection, improves quality of rapid TB diagnosis, early diagnosis in repeat time, because the seminar takes hardly in 2 hours, it will detect whether it is Mycobacterium TB or not, along with it whether it is rifampicin resistance or not. And a new diagnostic method is coming up, that is the TrueNAT. You see, the mechanism is same as that of seminar, but here the seminar is a cartridge based, but here it is a chip based, and here you can use it in a point of care, portable, rapid, battery operated, and it, the total time taken is hardly 1 to 1.5 hours. So the new technical and operational guidelines were disseminated in 2016. Coming to the standards for TB care in India. So why do we need a standard for TB care in India? Because as I told you, our doctors are well read and knowledgeable to identify, diagnose and treat a case of tuberculosis. But when the survey was conducted, and two such surveys was conducted in Mumbai, you won't believe that they got around 85 varieties of anti-TB prescriptions. 85 varieties of anti-TB prescriptions, and none of the prescriptions were correct. And even there are prescriptions from the specialist, TB and chest specialist. Either the dosage was incorrect, either the regimen was incorrect, the timing was incorrect, so something or the other was wrong. 85 varieties. So that is why, and then to coming to the diagnosis part also, some medical officer prescribed, you go for X-ray. Sometimes there is no need for X-ray, you go for ESR, some other blood test, you go for microdot, you go for stool, urine, like that. So unnecessarily time consuming and tests we are carried out. So that's why government of India thought that there should be a minimum criterion set, how to identify, how to diagnose, put the patient on treatment, follow the public health action, so that we get a logical outcome. So that is why the standards for TB care was disseminated in 2012. So there are total 26 standards. If you have an opportunity to go through it, please go through it. The standard for TB care is a very informative booklet. The diagnosis standards are set in standards for 1 to 6, then from 7 to 11 pertaining to the treatment, then from 12 to 21 the public health action, and 22 to 26 the social inclusion. Because as I told you, just by giving anti-TB drugs we don't cure TB. It has to be a multifaceted approach. Coming to the type of patients, so you see, classification of TB can be done in various, as I told you, if you go for anatomical classification, it is either pulmonary TB or extrapulmonary TB. If you go for the treatment, whether it is a drug sensitive TB or a drug resistant TB, then what is whether it is a new case or an old case. So new case, as you know, that any patient who has been diagnosed of having tuberculosis and has never taken any anti-TB medications throughout his lifetime, or if at all he has taken anti-TB medications from any source, whether it is public or private, but the total duration being less than 1 month, will be taken as a new TB case. And who has taken more than 1 month, irrespective of the source, is a previously treated case. So that has to be kept in mind. Coming to the background, you see earlier when this DOTS program started, we have this 4-drug regimen, but they were in blister packs. So separately, he had to take 2 tablets probably of ethambutol, 1 capsule of rifampicin, 2 tablets of pyrazinamide likewise. But now that has been given away, and now we have come up with the FDC or the fixed dose combination. So they are like in other programs that are being used as the National AIDS Control Program, the National Vector-Borne Diseases. So they also thought that why not to go for this fixed dose combinations. So what are the advantages? The advantages is simplicity of treatment, increased patient acceptance. So you see, earlier when we are giving this DOTS mechanism, say a category 1 patient or a new patient was taking around 7 to 8 pills, 2 tablets of pyrazinamide, 2 of ethambutol, 2 of ILH, 1 of rifampicin. But here in each tablet all the 4 components are there, ethambutol, ILH, rifampicin, pyrazinamide. So what happens, as per the wet band of the patient, he will swallow either 2 or 3 or 4 tablets, and each tablet will be having all the 4 ingredients. And the most important thing is there is no cherry picking. So you cannot select out, no, I am not feeling well, today only I will take the rifampicin capsule, I will leave away with the ethambutol or ILH. So that is a dangerous. No treatment is better than haphazard treatment. Remember, no treatment is better than haphazard treatment, because if you take the drugs, just 1 drug or 2 drugs as per your wish, so it will build up resistance. So here if you are taking the pills, means you are taking all the 4 drugs. So that will help you prevent the resistance. Then for the management of the logistics, patient compliance, so this is advantage. So that is why now they are advocating this FDC. Earlier in the DOTS mechanism, that was called an intermittent regimen. That means the patient used to take the drugs on alternative days. Either it was a Monday, Wednesday, Friday schedule, or a Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday schedule. But here in this FDC, that will be DOTS. That means direct observation of treatment, short course. But it will be a daily DOTS. Daily DOTS. So 7 days a week. So 1 month means it is taken in RNTCP or NTP as 28 days. So single daily dose, 4 weeks per month means 28 doses, no extension of IP. Earlier in this RNTCP, when the intensive phase, which was around for 2 months, if at the end of the intensive phase, the follow-up sputum microscopy was positive, the intensive phase was being extended by 1 month. Because we did not have the infrastructure to go for a culture DST. But here, once it is intensive phase is over, means the patient, there is no increase in intensive phase, the patient sample has to be sent for the culture DST and the patient has to switch over to the continuation phase. So this is the drug schedule and this is the dosage for the adults and also the pediatric cases. So you see 4 FDC means all the 4 drugs, ethambutol, INS, rifampicin and pyrazinamide. So each tablet will having a certain, say 75 mg of rifampicin, 200 mg of ethambutol, 150 mg of INS. So each pill will be having 4 drugs. So depending upon the weight band of the patient, he has to swallow either two pills or 3 pills or 4 pills or 5 pills. 3 FDC. So this will be used in the continuation phase. So in the intensive phase, you require 4 drugs. In the continuation phase, you require the isoniazid, rifampicin and ethambutol. There is no role of pyrazinamide in the continuation phase. So that is why the 3 FDC. Similarly, for the pediatric cases, in the intensive phase, you require 4 drugs. But ethambutol cannot, these are all dispersible tablets. So ethambutol cannot be kept along with this 3 FDC because of the instability. So that is why along with this 3 FDC, ethambutol is kept separately and it will be added up with them. Similarly, in the continuation phase, 2 FDC because pyrazinamide has no role along with the ethambutol. Coming to treatment of tuberculosis, which is the first line treatment, so it is based usually on the drug sensitive. So if it is a drug sensitive TB, new or previously treated, but it has not detected rifampicin resistance. It is a drug sensitive TB. So the intensive phase, IP means intensive phase, you have HRZD, 2 months, 2 means 2 months. 2 months of INS, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, ethambutol, daily dosage for 2 months. Then the patient is switched over to the continuation phase of CP, 4 months with 3 drugs, the 3 FDC, as I was telling you, HRE. There will be no extension of IP. Earlier there was an extension of IP. If at the end of the IP the smear microscopy was found to be positive, there was an extension of IP. But here, henceforth, there will be no extension of IP. The continuation phase can be extended in certain special situations like CNS TB, skeletal TB, disseminated TB, based on the decision of the treating physician. Extension beyond 12 weeks should only be recommended by the expert in the consult field. Loose drug should be needed as substitution in case of drug reaction. And remember, streptomycin, which was earlier in the first line, is no more being used. It is no more in the first line. It is used as the reserve drug or as a substitute drug. No more routinely in the first line. So you see, the as per the weight bands which I was telling you, that the patient who is diagnosed as a drug sensitive TB, if he belongs to, say he is having 36 kg of weight, so in that case, he will come to the second band, that is from 35 to 49. So in the intensive phase, he will be taking 3 pills. And similarly, in the continuation phase, he will be taking 3 FDC, 3 pills. So adult new patient, after being initiated on treatment, whose weight band increase or decrease by 5 kg or more, compared to the baseline weight, crosses the current weight band range during the course of treatment, the weight band must be changed to the time of issuing the drug. So these are issued monthly. These drugs are issued monthly. Suppose the patient was around 48 kg. So he began with the second weight band. Say 3 drugs in the intensive phase and 3 drugs in the continuation phase. Suppose after a couple of months, suddenly you find his weight has become around say 53 or 54 kg. So he has now crossed that weight band. So by the time the next month drug is issued, they should be in the range of from 50 to 64. Similarly for the children, so intensive phase 3 FDC plus ethambutol, which is kept separately, and similarly in the continuation phase HR and ethambutol. So you see, there is a mechanism in this system that, you know, children who are 5 years or below are very, very susceptible to this disease, and if at all they get tuberculosis, it will be in a very deadly form, like the miliary tuberculosis or the TB meningitis, where the mortality rate is very, very high. So in order to prevent these children from tuberculosis, so earlier the kg body weight, but now it has been increased to 10 milligram per kg body weight. So say a patient, a baby who is weighing around 20 kgs, so 10 means 200 milligram INS tablet he will be taking daily for 6 months. Earlier this was given to these pediatric cases who were in contact with sputum positive cases only. But now the program advocates that those who are in contact with TB case, whether the index case was a positive case or a negative case, but was a TB case, and a child who is coming in contact with this should be given this chemoprophylaxis, it will prevent. Then coming to the long term follow up. Earlier, after the patient was getting cured or completed the treatment, the program lost account of the patient. But then it was found that there were few relapse cases which used to come. So for early detection of such relapse cases, the program is now advocating that even after the successful completion or cure of this patient, they should be followed up at 6 months interval, that is 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, 24 months for the next 2 years, so that if at all there is any symptom of A, they can again be tested and identified, so the treatment can start early. Coming to the private sector, so this is now one of the biggest challenges to the program. As you all know that India, not only for tuberculosis, for anything, around 40 to 70% of the patients are still in the private sector. And the private sector is very unregulated and chaotic, of which we have no data that what is happening in the private sector. So anybody who goes to the private sector, that doctor might be a good doctor, he might have identified the patient correctly, diagnosed him correctly, given the right treatment. But can he tell what happened to that patient after he has left this chamber? Whether he took the drugs currently or not, whether he successfully completed or not, whether there was any contact tracing, whether there were any symptomatics in the house, whether there was any chemoprophylaxis given to them. No, it's not possible. It is not, because this mechanism is not available in the private sector. So little, as I told you, there were 85 varieties of anti-TB prescriptions found in the Mumbai market. So little is known about the quality of treatment, including treatment outcomes. Engaging the private sector effectively is the single most important intervention required to achieve overall goal for the universal access of quality TB care. So first of all, when we are talking of quality TB care, we must ensure that even if the patient goes to the private sector, he gets a standard treatment, diagnosis and treatment, and he gets a logical outcome. And if you are thinking of eliminating tuberculosis by 2035 or 2025, so unless you engage the private sector, we cannot do it along with the public sector. So delivery of TB care in the private sector, so that is why the standard for TB care, that even if you treat or identify a patient in the private sector, you must adhere to these norms. About 70% of the patients seek care in the private clinics and hospitals. They include a wide range of care providers, medical practitioners, allopathy, Indian system of medicine, homeopathy, paramedics, traditional healers, NGOs, nursing homes, corporate hospitals, healthcare institutions. What are the regulatory mechanisms? First is the standard for TB care in India, mandatory TB notification. Okay, you treat the patient in the private sector, but you must notify to the public, so that in the health system we know that yes, 5 patients are being treated by Dr. So and so, and whatever support is required, the system will provide. Ban on serodiagnostics, you should not write all those tests which are telling. Then amendments of the H1 schedule drug control, so that You know, in India, any drug is available in the chemist shop. You go and ask for any drug, they'll provide you, even the anti-TB drugs. So now government of India has made mandatory that they have to fill up the H1 schedule, that even if you give anti-TB drugs, you must keep the details which medical officer has prescribed, which private practitioner has prescribed, so that we can trace the patient and give the available support. Why? What are the advantages and disadvantages between the public and private sector? So if you see the public sector, the advantages being free diagnosis, free treatment, standard regimen, referral and transfer system. The patient tells, sir, mu jibi bari Sundargarh mor seti chakiri hei jai ki mu seti kaibi. There is a mechanism to send the information to that place so that where the patient goes and resides over there, the support is given, the medicines are given in time, so that he completes a logical way. This is not available in the private sector. Supervision and monitoring, accountability of treatment outcome. Coming to the private sector, there is a wide choice. The patient has the advantage. He wants to show to Dr. So and so. He is not available in the OPD or on that said day. So he goes to his chamber. That is one advantage. Better access, convenient timing, shorter distance, personal attention and care. Sir, go chamber ko gale, sir, tiya bhalsa dekhi me. Iti outdoor ekte bhiro hoji, stethro bhi pakeyo time nahi. Projected discounts. Medical officers to tell, tamai ei test gula karibo, it is 2009, thik achi mo reception dekhila, tamai 200 taka kom heijibo. And the faith also, because over the generations, they have been being treated by Dr. So and so, they have faith in him, so naturally they will go to him. Coming to the disadvantages in the public sector, you know, the staff may be unresponsive, delay between test and results, difficult in transportation, financial expenses of expenditure in travelling, medicine, extra medicines, perceived low quality. The big thing is that people still have a belief that hospital that you also the miluchi, there are some substandard also the gura. Again, baharu likhi diyantu. They will insist. But tell them, assure them, these drugs are quality tested drugs. These drugs are quality, rampantly they are being tested so that unless you have good quality drugs, we cannot claim a cure rate of 90% or more. Coming to the private sector, everything is expensive, starting from the doctor's fee, the tests, the medications, and as I told you, irrational prescriptions, no adherence or tracking mechanism. This is very important. Once the patient, you have correctly diagnosed the patient in the private sector, you have given the correct medication, everything. But as I told you, you cannot track the patient. It is minimum of 6 months or more. So you cannot track the patient. Fear of losing the patient, and private practitioners still believe that patient ko jadi mu refer kari devi, I lose the patient. No sir, I assure you, there is a mechanism in the system where you will not lose the patient, rather the patient will have more confidence in you, that sir ko te jodi ki pati jala, bhalo jaga ko pati jala, thik jaga ko pati jala. So as I told you, the schedule, H1 drug warning, it is dangerous to take prescription or preparation excepting in accordance with the medical advice. So anti-TB drugs, it has been told not to sell like that without a prescription from a registered medical practitioner. Then TB notification, it has become mandatory by 7th of May 2012. The first amendment been coming in 21st of July 2015 and the second amendment in 19th of March 2018. If you are treating a patient in your private chamber, it is mandatory for you to inform the health system. Then the ban on the serological test for TB in India, the manufacture, sale, distribution, use and import. This has been notified on 7th of June 2012. There is, as I told you, there is no serological test as of now to diagnose tuberculosis. So please don't prescribe these irrational tests of TB, gold, then this microdot and all those things. Coming to the TB notification at the carrot and stick. So what are the incentives? You see, private providers, 1,500 and notification and 500 and treatment. If you are treating a patient in your chamber, if you have notified, your chemist or your pharmacist or your health staff who is giving the medication, if he has notified the patient, you get 500. And if he takes the treatment correctly and gets a logical outcome of cure, again 500 rupees will be given. Patients, 500 per month. Government of India has given that any TB patient who is diagnosed of TB will get 500 per month directly, direct cash transfer to his account till the completion of the treatment. Nikshay Poshan Yojana, MPY. Tribal patients will get around ₹750 for travel allowances if they are travelling from remote places to the headquarters hospital or to the PHI. Treatment supporter, the person who gives the medication daily till the completion of the patient gets cured, they will give 500 on notification, 500 on outcome. And informant, suppose you have sent a patient to the health system and he is diagnosed as TB, all information will get ₹500. So you see, these are the advantages also. The STIC methods, mandatory notification from laboratory, private practices and hospitals and chemists. Public health action by health staff, counseling, home visit, treatment adherence, HIV, diabetes mellitus, this cannot be treated by the private practitioner alone. Here the health system will come in. Once the patient is notified, the health system will make the arrangement, they will go make a house visit, go for contact tracing, go for counseling, patient adherence till he gets a logical outcome. And if not, if you are not notifying, remember Act of Omission IPC 269 and Act of Commission IPC 270, you will be penalized. So this is the notification format which has to be in your clinic or private setup which will fill up. The health system will go on a particular day to your system, collect the data and come, and whatever support is required they will also provide. Then coming to 99 dots, this is a beautiful mechanism of information communication technology for patient adherence, particularly for patients having TB and HIV. So here you see they have been developed a very wonderful system how to monitor the patient. Suppose as per the patient weight band, he is supposed to take 2 pills per day. So you see on every second pill, there is a telephone marking. There is a telephone marking. So when the patient takes the pill at his home, and if there is no information given, that means the same afternoon, the TB health visitor or the senior treatment supervisor will come to the patient house and tell why you have not taken the pill, what was the problem, and try to bring him to track. So you see, wonderful mechanism of this ICT has been taken for this treatment adherence of the, particularly for the TB HIV. And that is called as 99 dots. So a missed call is to be given by the patient. Here in the dashboard in the center, you see all the green areas are the days when the patient has given the missed call. The days he has not given, there is a pink marking. So that indicates the patient has not taken the pill, so that the person from the health system will go to his house and ensure why the patient has not taken the pill and ensure that he takes the pill. Next we come to drug resistant TB. Yes, sir. So you know drug resistant TB, I have told you little before this presentation. What are the causes of drug resistant TB? So broadly it can be divided into three parts. One is the microbial, second is the clinical, and the third is the programmatic. So microbial, as you all know, it could be a genetic mutation. Clinical, inadequate or poorly administered treatment, and programmatic, a badly controlled TB program. So when the NTCP was there, National TB Control Program, we tell it was a badly controlled TB program because the detection was very poor, around 30%, deaths were more than 50% and chronic was more than 30%. But RNTCP we tell that it is a good program because if you adhere to the guidelines of NTP or RNTCP, the cure rate can go up to more than 90% and the chronic will be hardly 2%. So causes of drug resistance, you see, inadequate regimens, as I told you, varieties of prescriptions in the market, absence of guidelines, inappropriate guidelines, non-compliance with the guidelines, inadequate training of the health staff, no monitoring of treatment, poorly organized or funded TB programs. Drugs, non-availability, certain drugs. Suppose earlier when the NTP program was going, you must be remembering, patient used to come to the DTC and 3 drugs were usually given. Sometimes 1 drug was not there, out of stock. ତମେ 2টা ଔଷଧ ନେଇକି ଖାଉଥାଅ ଆର ମାସ ଆସିଲା ବେଳକୁ ଯଦି ଆସିବ ନହେଲେ କିଣିକି ଖାଇବ ତା ପାଖରେ ପଇସା ନାହିଁ ସେ କିଣିପାରିଲାନି ଆର ମାସ ସେ ଆସିପାରିଲାନି ହି ୱେଣ୍ଟ ୱିଥ୍ ଦ ଟୁ ଡ୍ରଗ୍ସ ସୋ ପୁଅର କ୍ୱାଲିଟି ପୁଅର ଷ୍ଟୋରେଜ କଣ୍ଡିସନ ଦିସ୍ ଟିବି ମେଡିକେସନ୍ସ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ବି particularly these anti-TB drugs or the drug resistant variety has to be kept in a particular temperature, otherwise it is a humid atmosphere, it will get spoiled. Then inadequate drug intake, unobserved treatment. What happened earlier in the NTP era? What happened? The main reason was the patient was given anti-TB drugs for 1 month at a time, and then the next month he was supposed to come and collect. ସିଏ ଘରକୁ ନେଇକି ଗଲା ପରେ ସିଏ ଖାଇଲା ନ ଖାଇଲା ଭୁଲିଗଲା ହେ ଆଜି ଓଷା ଅଛି ମୁଁ ଖାଇପାରିବିନି ଆଜି ମୁଣ୍ଡ ବୁଲାଉଛି ମୁଁ ଖାଇପାରିବିନି ଏ ଆଜି ଭୁଲିଗଲି ସକାଳୁ ଔଷଧ ଖାଇବା ଇଭିନ୍ ପେସେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଆର୍ ଟେକିଂ ଡାଇବେଟିସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଇପରଟେନ୍ସନ୍ ମେଡିକେସନ୍ସ ଦେ ଆର୍ ସପୋଜ୍ ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ ଡେଲି ସଡ଼ନ୍ଲି ୟୁ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଏ ହେ ତରତରେ ଭୁଲିଗଲି ଆଜି ଔଷଧ ଖାଇବାକୁ ଇଟ୍ ହ୍ୟାପନ୍ସ ଫର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଫୁଲନେସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ନ୍ୟାଚୁରାଲ୍ ଫେନୋମେନ ଅଫ୍ ଏନି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ ଟୁ ରିମେମ୍ବର କରେକ୍ଟଲି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟେକ୍ ଆଣ୍ଟି ମେଡିକେସନ୍ ଡ୍ରଗ୍ସ ଫର୍ ୱାନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଫ୍ ଇୟର୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଆବ୍ନର୍ମାଲିଟି ଅନସୁପରଭାଇଜ୍ ଡ୍ରଗ୍ସ ଫର୍ ଟେକିଂ ସଚ୍ ଏ ଲଙ୍ଗ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ନେଲେ ତ ଭଲ କଥା କିନ୍ତୁ ନବା ସ୍ୱାଭାବିକ ନୁହଁ ରାସ୍ତାରେ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ଆପଣ ଜୀବନ କାଳ ଭିତରେ କେବେ ଆକ୍ସିଡେଣ୍ଟ ହେବନି ଆଇ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ କେହି ନହେଲେ ଜଣେକି ଆସି ପିଟିଦେବ ସୋ ଇଟ୍ ହ୍ୟାପନ୍ସ ସୋ ବଟ୍ ହିୟର୍ ଇନ୍ ଡଟ୍ସ ବି ଏନ୍ସିଓର ବି ଟ୍ରାଇ ଟୁ ଏନ୍ସିଓର ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦି ପେସେଣ୍ଟ ଟେକ୍ସ ଦି ମେଡିକେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାଇ ଏ ଟ୍ରିଟମେଣ୍ଟ ସପୋର୍ଟର ଇଜ୍ ରିକ୍ୱାର୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ପ୍ରେଜେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ହୁମ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଟେକ୍ ଦ ମେଡିକେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହିୟର୍ ସି ୱିଲ୍ ଗିଭ୍ ଏ ଟିକ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଟ୍ରିଟମେଣ୍ଟ କାର୍ଡ ୟେସ୍ ଦି ଡ୍ରଗ୍ ହାଜ୍ ବିନ୍ ଟେକେନ୍ ଅର୍ ଦି ଆଇସିଟି ମେକାନିଜମ୍ ଅଫ୍ 99 ଡଟ୍ସ ବଟ୍ ଦି ପେସେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ସପୋଜ୍ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ଏ ମିସ୍ କଲ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁ ଏନ୍ସିଓର ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦି ପେସେଣ୍ଟ ହାଜ୍ ଟେକେନ୍ ଦି ଡଟ୍ ବିକଜ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଇଫ୍ ୱିତ୍ 95% ଅଫ୍ ମୋର୍ ଆଡିୟରାନ୍ସ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଏନ୍ସିଓର ଏ ଆଉଟକମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମୋର୍ ଦେନ୍ 90% ଅଫ୍ କ୍ୟୁର୍ ଅଦରୱାଇଜ୍ ଦ ସେମ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ହ୍ୟାପନ୍ So, prevention of DRTB or drug-resistant TB, strong systems to detect early, successful treat and ensure long-term disease-free. So, as I told you, that when even if the patient gets cured in the first line of treatment, the next 2 years of follow-up is very, very important because usually these relapses occur within the first 2 years. And if you are monitoring the patient correctly, even if there is a relapse, you can detect early and treat early and so that the patient gets cured again. System for early detection, earlier we did not have the mechanism, now the seminar is there, we have the liquid culture, we have the TrueNAT. Healthcare facilities and congregate settings to focus on proper infection control measures, measures to prevent incidence of transmission of tuberculosis. Then move to patient-centric care. So this program has been devised for the patient-centric care, that the patient is the VIP of the program, remember. For the patient, the program is there, we are there. It is not the vice versa. So how it will be suitable to the patient, where it will be convenient for the patient to take the drugs, what time the patient will be available, the arrangement has to be made accordingly. And at the same time, confidentiality, dignity of the patient should be protected. Health system responsibility, you remember, this is one program where the responsibility of cure lies with the system, not with the patient. The system gives a guarantee that if you adhere to it, we will ensure an outcome of cure. Then coming to universal drug susceptibility testing. Program is committed to provide universal drug susceptibility testing, UDST, for all notified TB patients. That means the patient has the right to know that even if he has tuberculosis, that whether it is drug sensitive TB or drug resistant TB right from the beginning. So that in the first fortnight, he knows yes, I am having a DSTB or a drug resistant TB. And that is the right. Because this was not available earlier. This mechanism, because the laboratory setup had not, the infrastructure was not there. So now we have a battery of tests like the cartridge based nucleic acid amplification test, the seminar, which is a cartridge based, or the TrueNAT, which is a chip based. Then the line probe assay. Moreover, the liquid culture, which is the gold standard, it is still there. Then concept of decentralization. Earlier when this PMDT was rolled out, we piloted it in 4 districts. Cuttack, Bhubaneswar, because Bhubaneswar is taken as a RNDCP district, Khordha and Ganjam. So these 4 districts were piloted. And now gradually it is being disseminated to the periphery because the patient need not travel for a TB care. Everybody need not come to Cuttack or Bhubaneswar or to Ramkala or to MKCG Medical College. Even at the district level, these things can be managed. And drug sensitive TB and H. monopoly can be managed even at the PHI level, even in any PHC or CHC. Gradually you see a program is designed with the infrastructure, with the budget and with the gadget so that accordingly with time you move. Gradually it was centralized, now we have the resources, so we are gradually decentralizing. So process of establishing the nodal or the district DRTB center. DRTB center must be in close proximity with the CPNAT or LPA laboratory. establish a nodal district or DRTP center committee, outdoor facilities, specialist trained, manage ambulatory patients from the OPD. Airborne infection control is an important thing. Operate with the public sector institutions or private sector institutions. So DRTP centers will continue to be attached to the nodal. You see, so in every district, we have a DDRTP center or the district DRTP center, and they will be attached to the nearest medical college, which will be the nodal center for DRTP. So process of establishing this nodal or district DRTP center, it has become mandatory by Government of India now. So mandatory provision to establish treating, initiating centers for DRTP centers in each medical college. So that is the main purpose of this program, that in a medical college, it is mandatory to have a nodal DRTP center. So, nodal DRTP center will be responsible for the initiation and management of drug-resistant TB patients of a specific group of complicated DRTB patients like additional resistance to second-line drugs, drug intolerance, contraindications, failing regimen, patient returning after treatment interruption of more than 1 month, emergence of any exclusion criteria for standard regimen, non-bacterium tuberculosis or DNTMs. So these are the special situations where the nodal TB center has come into play. Otherwise, all of the regimens can be started at the district level. So the nodal DRTB center committee composition, sir, I will request you that this is the composition which should be done immediately. The chairperson will be the medical superintendent, sir. The vice chairman, the head of the respiratory or the medical medicine department. Then we have members from all the HODs, Professor Microbiology sitting right in front. The psychiatry, gynecology, ENT, pharmacology, pediatric physicians, eminent pulmonologists, consultants, district where NDRTB is located, details of the district link. So this is the committee which has to be formed. I hope it has been formed. Then requirements from the institution. So these nodal DRTB centers should preferably be a tertiary care health center like in the department or medicine department. Separate ward, male and female, should be available for at least 10 beds in each NDRTB center. Then, sir, 10 bed nihati rahayaku padiba, nale MCI madhya object kariba. Then, tadare apana 6-4 kar dei paribe, male, female, kariki kintu 10 bed rahiba. All PMD services, beds, investigations, ECG, ancillary drugs for management of adverse drug reactions should be provided free of cost to the patient. The program will not allow the any expenditure from the patient. Apan seta parang reimburse kari parive apan program ro, kintu patient will not pay anything. Relevant specialists including respiratory medicine, general medicine, psychiatry, dermatology, ENT, ophthalmology, gynecology, pediatrician, anesthetologist, cardiologist should be directly linked. Because once you start this drug-resistant TB medication, a lot of adverse reactions are expected in around more than 40% of the cases. So keeping these faculty or HODs from different departments is that how to tackle, their expert opinion will come into play. That is the basic idea of having so many persons in the committee. NDRTB committee is to be formed, national training of the NDRTB members including the chairperson. So Dr. Khan is there, so please ensure that at least 2-3 persons from the different departments are trained in this. A full 1 day training at least is required, sir. So national airborne infection guidelines, routine clinical laboratory investigations, pre-treatment evaluation and monitoring, ancillary drugs should be available, management of adverse drug reactions, doctors, nursing, support staff should be available from the institute, records and reports, quarterly reports to be submitted electronically. So functions of the nodal center will be, sir, pre-treatment evaluation. This is very, very important because as I told you, these anti-TB drugs in the DRTB treatment are very, very toxic and a lot of them have side effects. So before you begin this treatment, there should be a baseline of all the values, the test should be there. Then counseling, you have to tell the patient that see, that time probably you did not take the first line drug correctly or routinely, you did not adhere for which you have landed up in such a situation, but there is nothing to lose hope because we have a mechanism. If you take the drugs correctly and if you adhere to the guidelines, you might get cured. Then treatment initiation of the DRTB patients, coordination with the culture DST labs, NICSA entry, travel awareness, follow of monitoring, management of adverse drug reaction, because adverse drug reaction is very, very important, particularly at the medical college side. Because you see, the success rate of MDR-TB is hardly 40 to 70%. Best is 70%, otherwise 40 to 60%. 20% will die. 20% will have adverse, serious adverse effect. Unless you adhere to this adverse drug reaction immediately, patient cannot continue. So, koi ho, sir, mai dio pache bo osudha khai paribeni. And earlier when we are giving this pass, even if it is used now in certain situations, it is so bitter. It is so bitter you won't believe. Patient just can't. So, sir, these are all kinds of sugar values. So at times you are advocated the pachla kadoli ki chokti ki ta bhitar ta ko bharti kari, just swallow it. So many drugs are there which are very, very toxic, but at the same time, if still we can manage the adverse drug reaction, we can get cure rates ranging from 40 to 70%. So coming to the definition and classification of DR-TB, all notified TB patients, because those are even having TB, we do not know right from the beginning whether it is a drug, it is TB, but whether it is a drug sensitive or drug resistant, we do not know. So that is why seminar is to be done within the first 15 days. Remember, don't send any sample, follow-up sample for seminar. Please keep this in mind. Don't send any follow-up sample. And moreover, seminar is mainly used for these extra pulmonary samples, but stool, urine, blood should not be sent. Stool, urine, blood should not be sent for seminar. No follow-up sample for seminar. Please ensure this. Then follow-up positive microscopy including treatment failures, any clinical non-responders. So directly you can send seminar or NAT sample for patients who are having extra pulmonary TB, as I told you. People living with HIV, because of the possibacillary nature, seminar is much more sensitive than their microscopy. Smear negative with X-ray suggestive of TB. DR-TB contacts. Suppose there is a patient who is having drug-resistant TB. Somebody is coughing in his house. So you should suspect that probably he has got drug-resistant TB and from this person. So in that case, a DR-TB contact should be directly sent for seminar. So universal DST, as I told you, refers to rapid DST for at least rifampicin among all notified TB patients within the first 15 days. You start the first line treatment, but within the first 15 days, collect the sample, send it for seminar to rule out whether it is rifampicin resistance or sensitive. And for that DST, if it is rif resistance, then it is subjected for second line, that is fluoroquinolones and the second line injectables. So classification of DR-TB, it depends monoresistant. If it is found to be resistant to only one drug, then it is known as monoresistance. Then polyresistance, if it is found to two or more drugs, excepting INH and rifampicin. Excepting INH and rifampicin, it is found to two or more drugs, it is polyresistance. RR resistance, if it is found resistant to rifampicin, then it is known as RR resistance, and it is also taken as drug resistant. Remember, if it is found, you can tell it, why you will not call it monoresistance? Because it is only single drug? No. Because you know that rifampicin has been the kingpin of chemotherapy of the first line treatment. If it is rifampicin resistant, means it is taken as rif resistant, means it is a drug resistant TB. Coming to multi-drug resistant, if it is resistant to rifampicin and INH, remember, rifampicin and INH, with or without resistance to any other drug, it is termed as MDR or multi-drug resistance. XDR-TB, so if a multi-drug resistant, that means don't have been resistant to INH and rifampicin, and along with it, it is resistant to one of the fluoroquinolones or the second line injectables, then it is known as XDR-TB. Coming to the rapid molecular resistant methods, you see, as I told you, there are two methods. One is by through the NAT machine and other is through the line probe assay. So NAT will detect, it is has two methods. One is the CBNAT or the cartridge based, other is the chip method or the TrueNAT. Then the line probe assay, the first line will detect only for INH and rifampicin, and the second line LPA for the fluoroquinolones and the second line injectables. And growth based phenotypic, you see the DST first line RHE, and second line is levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, kanamycin, linozoloid, clofamycin, bedaquiline, delaminate. So coming to this integrated drug resistant TB algorithm, you see all notified TB patients, as I told you, they should be subject for universal DST within 15 days. Non-responders, those who are drug sensitive or which are H monopoly on treatment, or people living with HIV, EPTB, smear negative, X-ray suggestive, vulnerable populations, contacted DRTB, they are all subject to NOT. You see the left hand side, if it is reef resistant, reef resistant not detected, that means reef sensitive. So what you start? You start with the first line treatment. Then simultaneously put the sample for the, send for the first line LPA. If it is H resistance not detected, you continue the treatment. If H resistance is detected, so in addition, whether it is resistant to second line LPA and liquid culture DST, you put it. Then all oral HL monopoly can be started, or if not, modify the regimen. Similarly, on the right hand side, if it is race resistance, first line LPA and second line LPA and liquid culture, presence of non-DST, that is the fluoroquinolones and the second line injectables. If there is no resistance, go with the shorter regimen. If there is a resistance, then all oral MDR regimen. This is to be started. So this has explained this. Then coming for all TB patients, if have been resistance not detected, first line LPA, that is H mono resistance detection. Then for all H mono or poly resistance detected, second line LPA, DST for pyrazinamide. For IMH and fluoroquinolone or Z, DST to moxifloxacin and linozoloid. Then careful history of the patients, clinical examination and investigation. It is important to try and get appropriate specimen from the children, failure to respond treatment, bacteriological confirmation. Then coming to probable TB. So this is used usually in case of pediatric cases. Criteria for diagnosis of probable MDR TB include children with signs and symptoms of active TB disease having the following risk factors: close contact with a known MDR case, close contact with a person who died while on treatment, close contact with a person who failed treatment, failure of the first line regimen, previous treatment with second line medication. So these children will be termed as probable. From the pediatrics are achanti, here sir, tick ke kindly dekhiye. Then pre-treatment evaluation. As I told you, this is very, very important before you start the drug resistant tuberculosis. Basically, history and physical examination, height, weight, random blood sugar, chest X-ray, HIV testing. These are to be done for H monopoly, but for MDR treatment or rifampicin resistance, you have to have a battery of tests, the CBC, blood, urea, serum creatinine, if you are using the shorter regimen where there is kanamycin injection, audiometry, if injectable is used, liver function test, thyroid stimulating hormone, urine examination, psychiatry evaluation if required, serum electrolytes, that is sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, if you are using the new drugs like betaquiline and delaminate, serum protein, ECG, if moxifloxacin, betaquiline and clofamizine are being used, urine pregnancy, this is very important for females who are in the childbearing age. You must ensure that they have not conceived. Then ophthalmologist's opinion, surgical evaluation. In majority of MDR DRT patients, pre-treatment can be done at the outpatient basis. You did not admit the patient, even from an outpatient you can do all these tests and a specialist consultation can be taken. Then treatment initiation, counseling, initial activities related to active drug safety monitoring, biochemical investigations, ECG, audiometry, initiate the patient on appropriate. So all these facilities should be available at the nodal DRTP center of the medical college. That is the basic idea of showing this. Then all basic, this patient should be basically counseled on details and nature of duration of treatment, information of new drug, whether they are given betaquiline or this delaminate, possible change in treatment, need of treatment adherence, possible side effect, consequences of irregular treatment or premature termination, then counseling or family planning. No written consent is required for undergoing this test or for this initiation of treatment. Then referral to MDR-TB center. If the patient is being treated at the DDRT center, they can refer the patient to the nodal DRTP center or to the medical college. If there is additional drug resistance, drug intolerance, contraindication, failing regimen, return after treatment of more than 1 month, emergence of exclusion criteria from standard regimen, management of any complication. So, how do you prepare a regimen for this DRTB patient, drug-resistant TB patient? So, they have broadly classified these drugs into three groups, group A, group B and group C. To make any regimen, we need at least 5 drugs. Remember, the basic idea is to have 5 drugs. So, in the intensive phase. So, from group A, you must take 3 drugs. So, either it is Limo or Moxi, along with it, Bedaquiline and Linozolid. So, 3 drugs from group A. WHO recommends 1 drug from group B, but India being a high prevalent country, we endorse 2 drugs from group B. So, it is usually clofamizine and or cyclosarin and terbinafine. So, out of this, you can add 2. So, 3 plus 2, 5 drugs. Group C will be a standby. In case of any intolerance or any adverse effect, that can be substituted from the group C. So that in the intensive phase, you have 5 drugs. In the continuation phase, after bedaquiline or delaminate is dominated, you have at least 4 drugs. This is the dosage schedule. There are weight bands, you see 16 to 29, 30 to 45, 46 to 70 and more than 70. So for different weight bands, you will prescribe the drug as per the dosage. Similarly, for the pediatric cases, those who are less than 30 kg. So, the standard regimen which has been fixed usually you see. So, for H mono or poly DR resistance, so total duration you remember is 6 to 9 months. Minimum is 6 months, maximum you can extend up to 9 months and these are the 4 drugs. Levofloxacin, rifampicin, ethambutol and pyrazinamide. Usually 6 months. If required, you can extend till 9 months. There is no IP and CP here. There is no intensive phase and continuation phase. Similarly, for MDR or RRTB, we have a shorter regimen which is 9 to 11 months. Here we have a intensive phase and a continuation phase. Intensive phase is usually 4 to 6 months. That is moxifloxacin, canamycin or amikacin, etionamide, clofazimine, pyrazinamide, INH high dose and ethambutol. So, 4 months. Continuation phase is fixed, remember. So, if it is 4 plus 5, it is 9 months. If it is extended, maximum 6 plus 5, it is 11. So, the total duration is 9 to 11 months. Then, all oral longer MDR regimen is 18 to 20 months. Bedaquiline for 6 months. Rest of the drugs to continue till 20 months. So, these are the basic 3 regimens of MDR. Remember, if the intensive phase is to be prolonged, the injectable agent is only given 3 times a week. So, daily you are giving injection in the shorter regimen. If you are extending the intensive phase, then you make it alternate days. Similarly, all oral or H monopoly regimen is of 6 months with no separate IP or CP. Shorter MDR regimen 9 to 11 months with 4 months to 6 months of IP with injectables and 5 months of CP. All oral MDR TB regimen is of 18 to 20 months with no separate IP and CP. New drugs like bedaquiline and delaminate can be given for 6 month duration while the dose of linozolid will be tapered to 300 mg after initial 6 to 8 months. So, this is the basic principle of having this resistance. So, all oral and monopoly, no specific exclusion criteria. But in shorter MDR regimen, you have the pregnancy, extra pulmonary disease with PLHIV, disseminated meningeal or central nervous system, intolerance to any drug. Or all oral longer regimen, it does not have. Bedaquiline is usually given to children for more than 18 years or patients more than 18 years. Delaminate can be given from 6 to 17 years. Clinical monitoring usually done after every 3 months. Assess clinical, microbiological, radiological response. Measure weight. Assess possible adverse drug reaction. Encourage the patient to continue treatment. Verify treatment card. So, these are the follow-up schedules. I am not going into the details, but these are the follow-up schedules. So, how you have to follow up with the cultures, mere microscopy and also the clinical part. So, follow-up schedule for shorter MDR regimen. So, particularly remember those who are taking injectables, you must be very, very cautious because there is a loss of audiometry. Suddenly, the patient attendant comes, So, the treatment supporter must be very keen and aware and alert about it. So, immediately they go for the audiometry, otherwise there is a permanent vestibular damage. moving from IP to CP. So shorter MDR regimen, smear at 4 months to be done. If it is negative, go for CP. If positive, extend IP by 1 month. If it is 6 months positive, then follow up the culture will be done. Similarly, for the longer regimen, monthly culture from 3 months onwards. If 5th and 4th month culture is negative, then initiate CP. If positive, extend IP by 1 month. So the follow-up microscopy to be done also simultaneously. Coming to interim outcomes, so culture conversion. So usually you see the patient, after 3 months when the samples are sent, if both the samples taken 1 month apart are found to be negative, we are telling that patient has culture converted. Agaru growth hodla, ebe agaru growth hodi, culture converted. So that is a good sign. Similarly, culture reversion, after becoming negative, if the next sample becomes positive, we tell it is culture reversion. It is also termed as treatment failure. Then these are the outcomes. Cured, a micromorphologically confirmed patient at the beginning of treatment who was smear negative at the end of complete treatment with at least one previous occasion is termed as cured. Treatment completed, who has taken the entire course of medication but could not do the culture due to some reason or the other, is given as treatment completed. Treatment failed, who is at positive at 5 months, we out of continue karegi treatment nahi, treatment failure. Died, remember, died, a patient died during treatment. The cause of death did not be TB. See, घर को जाओ तो लाभ आते हैं उसे तो कहीं की तो आपने कंट्री चली गला। हमें किन्तु outcome देखो died. He has not died of TB. So for irrespective of any reason, whether it is TB or non-TB, if during the treatment the patient dies, the outcome is died. That's all. Last to follow, the patient after starting treatment continuously has stopped the medication for 1 month or more. After 1 month, the outcome will be lost to follow. The जिन बात करते हैं इसला पूरी खाईला, that is not lost to follow. These are interruptions of treatment. Not evaluated. Patient has been transferred out to another place and you have not got the feedback. The outcome is not evaluated. Regimen change. During the course of treatment, suddenly you see the culture is positive, then you go for the second line, you see if it is resistant to some additional drugs. So that means you tell the treatment there is a change of regimen. So the similar thing for the MDR regimen and also for the longer regimen. The reporting part is usually done after 1 year, that is 12 months. Then coming to airborne infection control, this is very, very important, particularly in the medical college setting. Because you know these are all airborne infections, and now because of this pandemic, everybody is putting a mask. You should also put a mask, particularly in these settings also. So screening of the patients, acute febrile respiratory illness, cough for 2 weeks, cough etiquette, segregation, fast tracking of the patient, environmental controls and respirators. Surveillance and TB in the healthcare worker, educating and monitoring. So what are the mechanisms? Broadly, there are three mechanisms for this airborne infection control. First is the administrative, second is the environmental, and third is the respiratory personal protection. All the policies developed for infection control team, risk, procedure of implementing, enforcing and monitoring, these are administrative controls. Patient screening, apan jo kora respiratory cases ki amar jo covid rebe outdoor koragala or separate jagare koragala, kahi na we are expecting such type of patients to come over here. Jo to wait karibe, that should be a well ventilated area with the free sunlight over there, not in a crowded hall or in a closed room. It should not be. Fast tracking, jumping the queue, sethi asi chandi HIV center को बहुत लोग आते हैं यार टी मेडिकेशन दवा पे जो ना टीबी आउटर को रेफर है कि आसी चाहिए ताको आउट ऑफ द क्यू ताको आने की जल्दी सेटू ताको देखें कि विदा करवा रहा है जितनी की समस्या रही वो काशी वो छिंकी वो समझते कि इन्फेक्ट करेगी जीवो एंड दिस आर ऑल पेशेंट्स हु आर इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज ओवर देयर सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज फास्ट ट्रैकिंग और जंपिंग द क्यू सो स्क्रीनिंग टू आइडेंटिफाई पीपल विद रेस्पिरेटरी सिम्टम्स कफ एटिकेट आगर थला जे हम का करथलो रुमाल छिंकुतलो हाथरे छिंकुतलो नाउ दैट इज नो कफ इन योर एल्बो कफ इन बिकॉज आपन जतरा हाथ को छिंकु चंदी कि रुमाल कर जन स्टिल देयर आर अदर कंटामिनेशन एरिया वेयर यू आर टचिंग द नोज आपन देखिए सर्जरी ओडी रे कि हम करे से नर्स जदि ट्रेंड है दियो आपन को कळ बंद करिया को दबनी हाथ धोइला पर सर्जन को से छिड़ाइ दियो नले सर्जन निजे कोड़ी मारि के ताको बंद करिवो सो यू आर नॉट सपोज टू डू गाउन ताको से पिंदे दियो बिकॉज दिस आर मिनिमम इन्फेक्शन कंट्रोल मेजर्स व्हिच यू हैव टू टेक And the most infected material which was surveyed now, you can get the quota. Maximum infection can you get? Your mobile phone. Your mobile phone. Kintu ame kon korchu sei dorche je panna gote delu kai dela. We are happening because we are used to it, but then administrative control. Properly identify people with TB symptoms, ensure linen and waste management, clean and disinfect patient care equipment, package of preventing care interventions, observe standard precautions. Adequate ventilation, there must be minimum air exchange rate, bed should be around 6 feet distance. Amar kon hoji? Di feet re gotada bed, ta majre bi gotada patient. So this is ideally how a TB ward should be. The bed spacing should be minimum 6 feet. And you see the windows, the high roof, cross ventilation. So these are the minimum air exchange rates which should happen in a registration or waiting room, outpatient department, inpatient department, high risk setting, particularly ART centers, TB and chest departments, bronchoscopy rooms, MDR TB wards, airborne isolation rooms. Aba OPD guraka generally ei type ra dekhantu kintu emti hoba kata setting particularly for this chest symptomatics, whether it is tuberculosis or COVID-19, usually that should be a distancing. Sputum collection, say it kashi ki laboratory bhitar daba ko mana kari, open air collection, because the advantage is there is infinite dilution. Jadi bhi sada sputum positive case hai thiyo se concentrate nahi kout rahi bani, and as you know ultraviolet rays will kill most of the bacilli. So open air collection is always advisable. Environmental control, use ventilation system using ultraviolet germicidal irradiation, particularly exhaust fans, don't in raw emergency, at least minimum this can be put. Then personal protective equipment, PPE, other called N95 mask is always protective. Simple surgical mask or cloth to cover the cough or hygiene control at the patient level. Surgical mask apparently nahi kichhi labh nahi. Patient ko pai theek achi, se kasle ki chinkle the spillage area is minimized. Otherwise, surgical mask does not protect this AFB. AFB can freely enter the surgical mask, remember. So, only N95 is recommended. So, the National Strategic Plan from 2017 to 2025. So, engagement of the private sector, active case finding, TB with comorbidities, as I told you, if the patient is having TB, they are screened simultaneously for diabetes and HIV. Because unless diabetes and HIV are taken care of, TB is not going to be cured. Multi-sectoral response, drug-resistant TB, ICT tools for adherence and monitoring, and preventive measures. So what is DBT? Direct benefit transfer. As I told you, the financial benefit government dauji, say patient on Nikshay Poshan Yojana, till he completes treatment, every month 500 rupees will directly go to his account. Similarly, for the environment, from the private laboratories, for notification, for treatment outcome, khali setting in law, jadi apana treatment supporter kahara hela, and these incentives are only for non-salaried people, remember, johan garba pauchan is akhiri korten tanga pahin ho. And for patients who are treatment supporter, suppose a asha worker, kura patient ko jayi Delhi osudho khao chi, ebang se kiyo rahe gala, jadi drug sensitive TB hai to completion se bhai 1000 rupees, jadi drug resistant TB hai to they'll get 5000 rupees. Patient gets 500 rupees per month. The informant who sent the patient, if it is a TB, he gets 500 rupees. If he successfully cured, he gets 500 rupees. So these are all the advantages. The diagnosis is free, treatment is free, tracking mechanism, this is free, everything. Then public health action, one private practitioner notifies TB patient, information following the action will be taken by the local public health staff or general health staff. Patient or home visit for your general health system. Counseling of the TB patient, treatment adherence, contact tracing, symptoms of the contacts, they will be evaluated for tuberculosis, offering of HIV and drug sensitivity testing. So the slogan, the new theme which is coming up for 2021 is, the clock is ticking. Because we have given already the call to end tuberculosis by 2025 and Odisha is given for 2023. So all your efforts and cooperation are required. Thank you.
Dr. Sanjit Pottang, both Sar and Raghu Janchi, he is closely and deeply related to this TB subject since in the Gondar service also. And after retirement also he is working in the SCB as a national trainer. He is a national trainer. Pura state to state to jai training dhanti. As a TB class in LA, he can take for hours together, endless. Ajay Chanchala Sarai Vichanti. Our Dr. Khan ji ki medical officer district TB center at the Capital Hospital Rasam. Samane, our college Astor, we are grateful to them. मुतांकर नंबर रखी ची मुखाले दीर्घ चट्टा कथा अपनो कोया चाऊची सार जोड़ा जी प्रेजेंटेशन दिल्ले आमे शिरा प्रिंटर रखी चु अपनो को सब प्रिंट करी दो सो दैट पीडियाटिक हो मेडिसिन हो पुनर्निर्माण मेडिसिन हो रेस्पिरेटरी मेडिसिन समस्ते माइक्रोबायोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट समस्ते शिरा को रखी गिरी फॉर योर रेफरेंस सार जो कहले मेन कथा है ड्रग रेजिस्टेंस कथा रिसेंट रेजिमेंट जमी ए बॉडी वेट अनुसार तीन टा चार टा बटिका खाए को इंटेंसिव फेज कंटिन्यूशन फेज आ छोट कथा कह चाहे जे एच आई वी टीबी है गोटे कॉइन रे दीटा साइड पे से जहाँ एच आई पी टीबी टेस्ट टीबी टेस्ट ताको एच आई वी टेस्ट करिया अछि एटा गोटे ये तापर डायबेटिक मेलाटिस टीबी कॉमनली देखा जाए एच आई पेसेंट को आम टीबी टेस्ट करा टीबी पेसेंट एच आई टेस्ट कर तार बहुत मानते क्लोजली दे आर रिलेटेड आमर बर्तमान ये मलेरिया टीबी बोली दुटा चार रोग आम लोक जाटम बम के कौन प्रोग्रेस कले कि शह शह वर्ष है मलेरिया टीबीटा को आम इरेडिकेशन कर पारने मलेरिया जमी फास्ट थी आप जानते हैं NMEP कांथर लिखा था NMEP नेशनल इरेडिकेशन प्रोग्राम मॉडिफाइड प्लान NMEP नेशनल मलेरिया कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम बर्तमान अच्छी नेशनल वेक्टर डिसीज कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम जो थे कि सब जगह वेक्टर बॉर्न डिसीज मलेरिया फलेरिया डेंगू ये सब जगह मिसी सब नुआ जिन चेंज होती नेशनल टीबी कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम बर्तमान लास्ट को RNTCP थी बर्तमान मॉडिफाइड RNTCP रिवाइज नेशनल टीबी कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम सार जो कहले माने ये जो पेसेंट फेसेंट पर ट्रीटमेंट होची सेटा पे इंसेंटिव मते दे होची सार गोटे भलो कथा कहिसेंती आ आमे तांग संग कांटेक्ट रखिया हमर एक्चुअली मोर कहया कथा सार जोडा कहले गवर्नमेंट आ प्राइवेट सेक्टर रे हमर प्राइवेट सेक्टर रे मु देखुतली हमर ए जो सिबिनाट टेस्ट पे हमर टिके कमी होची आई विल रिक्वेस्ट ऑल प्रोफेसर सर्जरी मेडिसिन पुनो रेस्पिरेटरी मेडिसिन पीडियाट्रिक प्रोफेसर से अंदर डिपार्टमेंट जो आसंति फैकल्टीज प्रोफेसर माने जे हमरो ए जो सिबिना टेस्ट को ठीक आपन पेशेंट को कहि बढ़ा से नेगेटिव आसे पॉजिटिव किंतु आपन जा सस्पेक्ट कर छथि आपन पठांतु हमर सैंपल कलेक्शन में अछि ग्राउंड फ्लोर रे से फोटो पीडियाट्रिक साइड रे से सैंपल कलेक्शन करके हम सैंपल ठीक बढ़ांतु इटा तो फ्री रहउछि वी आर सेंडिंग टू कैपिटल हॉस्पिटल बुझले कि आ मु समस्त रिक्वेस्ट करी जे आमर टेस्ट एजेंसी बिना टेस्ट टिके बढ़ी कलेक्शन टा सैंपल कलेक्शन पेशेंट टू बढ़ातु मेडिसिन प्रोफेसर आसंती मेडिसिन जाएंगे सर भी थे जस्ट गले प्रोफेसर अन्य डॉक्टर अन्य पीके बराबर सब आसंती कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन आसंती जो प्रिवेंशन क्योर ड्रग रेजिस्टेंस होले समस्त टिके करंतु मु समस्त गोटे कॉपी करी समस्त सप्लाई कर दे सब डिपार्टमेंट को so that in the time of need you can have reference jota koile sa drug dose ho revised there have been recent amra bohire to tb er jota sa jota koile senta nahi jota koile chatta drug intensive phase re ho tinta drug continuous phase re ho se nua jaga amra bohire nahi sar government of india recent ye jaga sar koichanti ame we are thankful from our high tech medical college hospital side मु समस्त करेबी से जहाँ कर आई विल रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर मित्र ही हेज डायरेक्टर हेज बीइंग DTC हेड हियर ही हेज अरेंज अ वेरी गुड थिंग आर सबजा प्रोग्राम सक्सेस हुए यहाँ गोटे भल ही हेज कल डॉक्टर खान डॉक्टर संजीत पटनायक एज ए रिसर्च पर्सन वेरी गुड अरेंजमेंट थैंक यू सर प्लीज सर
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वेरी मच ग्रेटफुल टू डॉक्टर संदीप पटनायक हु हैज टोल्ड given the training in detail, starting from A to Z. So, the advantage of this training, by now you know very well. Khali mor etiki tike koibar achi, jehetu I have worked in HIV, I have gone on HIV training for years. So, joe patient amara ethi, National ICTC Center achi, Integrated Counseling and Testing Center. Jouthare seta first floor e hoichi and it is supported by OSAC, Orissa State AIDS Cell. And they are supported by NACO, National AIDS Control Organization. So I am sorry to tell, we are not doing the rapid screening test because the rapid screening test is 75% detectable for hepatitis B and C. 30% may escape. For that reason, I'm sorry to tell to all of my younger friends, many people do not know ICT center where it is situated, and we are doing microELISA. The microELISA testing serology kit is supplied by OSAC. So all TB patients, jya asuchi, HIV apan wale free of cost re kari paribe. Ab year to pranjala bhavare, aji being a microbiology, mubi anek jinsa jani na thili. Tenu, I am not a physician, mainly physician ko focus kari kwai chi, and advantage of TB patient financially kaun hava, tabi saar kari jade. तेरे प्राणियों वाले मूवी बहुत ज्ञानों आहारण कर लिए अपनों को पाकरों जो जिन सो देंगे माइक्रोबायोलॉजी थे कि मुझे जानी न थी ली तेरे आजी अपन वालों को खाली ऐतिहासिक अनुरोध आमर मेडिकल सुपरिटेंडेंट इज वेरी डायनामिक ही हैज प्रॉमिस्ड यू आप सारों को भी जो सास पीस दे ले मुझ मेडिकल सुपरिटेंडेंट आपन को सबु या कॉपी देबे किंतु मु आपन को अनुरोध करबी जे आपन माने ताको भलो भाबरे पढिबे भलो भाबरे यूटिलाइज करबे आउ हमर नॉन पल्मोनरी केस ठीके बेसेबो आउ गोटा भी आज आपन डिपार्टमेंट वेरीफाई करि परिबे ड्रग प्रोवाइडर और मु कंटेनर ऑफ सिविनाट भी दे दे के आसीछु इंडोर दे के आसीछु अब सिविनाट कैपिटल हॉस्पिटल में हो रही तीन टावर को देले आवे पढ़े ही पारी बुझो ताको लुक्का से तेरो आम जो दिया अपनों का तीन टावर को ऑपरेशन है ना अपनों सिविनाट करवा के चाहो जाती कंटेनर इज विथ यू यू कंटेन लेबल नेक्स्ट डे यू सेंड टू अस एंड विल गिव सर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज आई थैंकफुल टू यू टू गिव योर वैल्युएबल टाइम टू कम to our hospital and thank you all faculty. Another 10 minutes or 5 minutes kindly wait. The lunch has already arrived. So after receiving lunch and please give me 10 minutes time. On that time I will provide lunch. And before going sir, I will
Dr. Mamta Bhatt, Assistant Professor, Department of Microbiology.
Sir, after what should
do? Sir, I should.
Sir, I should. Sir,
after
what should I do? Sir, after what should I do? Sir, after what should I do? Sir,
देखंतु ओडिशा रे टीबी पे सब जगह रे सरकार को तरफ रो जन जागरण
सब डिफरेंट प्रकार मध्यम दासकाठिया हो पोस्टर मध्यम हो टीवी रे हो प्रचार करा एवं प्रत्येक पीएचसी सीएचसी टीवी रे चिन्हट एवं चिकित्सा पे सुविधा मध्य करा जाउची तेणु जहाँ को लक्षण यथा ज्वर दुई सप्ताह अधिका काश रक्त पड़ा ओजन कमी जा सन्ध्या टी ताति पुरे झाड़ दे ज्वर छाड़ा ओजन कमी जा सब लक्षण थी तेणु टीबी सन्देह करवा साधारणतः हुए प्राय प्रत्येक पीएचसी सीएचसी आम कफ परीक्षार सुविधा अच्छी से निज कफ परीक्षा करनी टीबी चिह्नट करागला तेणु संपूर्ण चिकित्सा चिह्नट पद संपूर्ण मागणा छ मास अति कम्रे औषध खाइबा को पड़ो एवं ये सुविधा ने छड़ा जो मैंने आशाकर्मी मैंने जो मैंने सन्देह करके पठाऊँ सरकार आर्थिक साहय सुविधा रखिंट जथा प्रत्येक इनफर्मेन्ट जहाँ केस टीबी बाहर ताको अति कम 500 टका गोटे टीबी केस चिह्नट करिया को मिलिबो एवं ता सहित जदि से ताको औषध खुआई भल करेला ताले मध्य 1000 टका मिलिबो जोटा हमर फर्स्ट लाइन ट्रीटमेंट बा ड्रग सेंसिटिव टीबी कहउचंदी एवं जदि तार ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी बाहरला एवं तार जदि चिकित्सा करी से संपूर्ण आरोग्य होला ताले ताको मध्य 5000 मिलिबो ता छडा गरीब लोक को पई हो जेकोनसी टीबी रोगी को पई हो चिकित्सा समय रे प्रत्येक मास डायरेक्टली 500 टका खाता को जीव जहाँ को आम निक्षय पोषण योजना तरफ दि जाऊँगी डायरेक्ट कैश ट्रांसफर हम ता छड़ा ट्राइबल पेसेंट मानक 750 टका अच्छी जीवा आसवापाई घर डाक्तखाना पर्यंत ए सुविधा कर तेणु ये सुविधा सुजोग ना उचित
आम नेशनल ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एलिमिनेशन प्रोग्राम ट्रेनिंग दे प्रोफेसर पटनायक जी नेशनल इंटरनेशनल फेमस आमर बहु डाक्तर आसी क्लिनिकल विभाग रे आमर अमित सर भी आसी मेडिकल ऑफिसर कैपिटल हॉस्पिटल तेणु आम सुपरिटेंडेंट डॉक्टर वासुदेव बेहरा आसी आज जो टाइप रो ट्रेनिंग है मुझे आशा करे मोर डाक्तर भाई मैंने क्लिनिकल एक्सट्रापल बनारी से पुंखानुपुंख बुझीथे ताकु एठी गाइडलाइन भी दिगला प्रश्न पचार समय भी दिगला तेणु आशा करे आपण मानकर सहयोग हेले हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज रे दिने ना दिने डॉट सेंटर खूब ना करिवो आउ आमे चाहू आमे सरकार हाथ को हाथ मिले ए टीवी को जमती आमे आम देश तड़ी देवाई व्यवस्था करवा धन्यवाद जय जगन्नाथ
दिस इज रोशन कुमार पाड़ी डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोग्राम कोऑर्डिनेटर कैपिटल हॉस्पिटल भुवनेश्वर वी आर वेरी मच ग्रेटफुल एंड थैंकफुल टू प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर जेपी मित्र सर हु इज द हेड ऑफ द जेनेटिक्स एंड इन्फेक्शियस कंट्रोल लैब ही इज ऑल्सो द आरएनटीसीपी डीएमसी डॉट सेंटर इंचार्ज ओवर हियर एट हाईटेक विथ हिज ब्लेसिंग्स एंड इमेंस कोऑपरेशन आरएनटीसीपी हियर एट हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज इज स्केलिंग न्यू हाइट्स एंड आई होप दैट वी विल ऑल्सो डू बेस्ट इन आवर फ्यूचर एंड विथ कोलाबरेशन विथ मित्र सर गवर्नमेंट विल डेफिनेटली स्केल न्यू हाइट्स इन द हाईटेक मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल।